Then one cloudy day, Harry Pebble assigned us a little horror called The Doom of the Catmen.
This the sort of thing you had in mind? Of course, they need freshening up. They've been hanging for quite a while.
I can't get into this thing.
Don't worry about it. If they don't turn around too much, a little muslin here will cover it up fine. This is a matter of fitting. We take care of that. We have a whole department for that. This may be a problem, unless you get a thinner man. You see, this material is imported. We can't get it anymore. But don't let that be an obstacle. Here, the perfect fit. This will give you the full effect. You see, lots of character in the tail, plenty of fright. Need a little puffing up, but it'll be all right. Of course, you got to visualize it in the lights. You got to use your imagination. Shoulder pads, straighten it right out. This'll give you the effect. It'll be good.
Look, put five men dressed like cats on the screen. What do they look like?
Like five men dressed like cats.
When an audience pays to see a picture like this, what do they pay for?
To get the pants scared off them.
And what scares the human race more than any other single thing?
The dark.
Of course. Why? Because the dark has a life of its own. In the dark, all sorts of things come alive.
Suppose we never do show the catmen.
Is that what you're thinking?
Exact. No catmen.
All right. Now, what do we put on the screen that'll make the backs of their necks crawl?
Two eyes, shining in the dark.
A dog.
Frightened. Growling. Showing its fang.
A bird. Its neck broken. Feathers torn from its throat.
A little girl screaming.
Claw marks down her cheeks.